Hello friends, hope you have subscribed to our channel and also checked out our courses available on our website www.letsuit.com. So let's start with today's session.
Welcome to the problem solving session of the chapter coordinate geometry. Today we'll solve a problem based on distance formula. We already have an idea about the distance formula from the previous sessions. We have already done some videos to explain the concept of distance formula. So here we are to solve this question. It says, find the point on x-axis which is equidistant from 2 minus 5 and minus 2, 9. So basically we need to understand that we need to find the third point which is equidistant from these two points. Okay, so let me write this. The third point is equidistant from 2 minus 5 and minus 2, 9. This is the first thing we need to know from the question, and the second thing we need to know that it is here. The third point, the required point, is on x-axis. Okay, so the point is lying on x-axis. First of all, we need to understand the setting over here of the question. Suppose the point 2 minus 5 is lying here, and the second point is minus 2, 9 is here. Since this is first point, let us say the x coordinate of the first point is x1, y coordinate of first point is y1, x coordinate of second point is x2, and y coordinate of second point is y2. And we need to find the third point, which we don't know the coordinates of the third point. So let us say the coordinates are x and y. Only thing we know is they are the two points are at equal distance from this point. Okay, so that is from the first condition. Now the second condition says the point is lying on x-axis. What do you mean by that? Let's understand that from this coordinate axis. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. Now we know that the points on x-axis we generally write in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4. What do we understand by that? This 1 is basically 1, 0. This 2 is basically 2, 0. This 3 is 3, 0. And this 4 is 4, 0. So what do we get from this? Whenever a point is on x-axis, its y coordinates, look at them, its y coordinates will be 0. Similarly, about this point, since this point is lying on x-axis, we will have y coordinate as 0. So this point finally looks like this, x, 0. Got it? Fantastic. Let's understand this with a real life example. Let's go down. There is a situation. We have two villages. This is village 1 and this is village 2. So for time being, let us say V1 for village 1 and V2 for village 2. And a government wants to build a hospital between village 1 and village 2, but the condition is distance from village 1 to the hospital should be equals to distance from village 2 to the hospital. That means, suppose D1 is the distance from village 1 and hospital, that is V1 and hospital, and let us say D2 be the distance from V2 to hospital, then D1 has to be equals to D2. Okay, so let's understand with this question. Suppose 2, minus 5 is the coordinate for village 1, and coordinates for village 2 say minus 2, 9. Then we need to find xy for the hospital, that means the coordinates of the hospital. And the condition is the hospital, that means the third point, is on x-axis, which we already know from the question. And we already said that when point is on x-axis, the y coordinates become 0. So now the coordinates of the hospital is x, 0. Fine? And let's work out this. What will happen? We know the distance formula, right? Suppose, I'll write over here. Suppose we have two points, x1, y1 and x2, y2. And we want to find distance between them. Suppose that distance is d. Then d will be equals to square root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. This is what we learnt. So let us apply that. Okay, let's go down a bit. Okay, let us first find distance 1, that is distance between village 1 and the hospital. So for that we will use the coordinates of village 1 and the coordinates of the hospital. So using the formula which says square root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. So for this reason let us take this 2 as x1, minus 5 as y1, and here let us take this x as x2 and this 0 as y2. Okay, fine, then let's apply this. What will happen here? Let us see. X1 is 2 and x2 is x whole square plus y1 is minus 5 and y2 is 0 whole square, correct? So after solving this, what we will get? Let us see. We have to apply a minus b whole squared formula. We all know that. What is a minus b whole squared? A squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So we have 2 in place of x and we have x in place of b, correct? So after applying that, what we'll get? We will get 2 squared, that is 4, minus 2ab, that is 4x, plus b squared, that is x squared. Okay, and here minus 5 minus 0 will be minus 5, correct? I'll write over here minus 5 minus 0 will be minus 5. So taking the squared, what we will get? We should get 25. So I'll apply here 25. Fine, after simplifying, what we'll get? We will get x squared minus 4x plus 29. Great. Similarly, let's find d2. Let's go down a bit. d2. Similar formula. We will apply x1 minus x2 the whole squared plus y1 minus y2 the whole squared. Okay. And here, for this reason, let us take this as x1 and this as y1, and we already have x2, y2. So let us apply that. What we will get here? We will get x1, that is minus 2, minus x2, that is x whole squared, plus y1, that is 9, correct? You can see here, minus y2, that is 0. Fine. So let's simplify this. We are going to apply a minus b whole squared formula as we did over here. So what we'll get? Let us see that. What we will get? A squared, that is minus 2, because we have, in this case, if we go a, we have minus 2 and b we have x, correct? So we'll apply the formula. We will get a squared, that is minus 2 squared minus 2ab, so 2ab plus b squared. And here 9 minus 0, what will be 9 minus 0? That is 9, and squaring them we will get 81. Fine, so this will be 81. So let us simplify this and see what we are getting. We will get minus 2 squared is 4, and this is plus 4x plus x squared plus 81. So after simplifying further, what we will get? We will get x squared plus 4x plus 85, because we have to add this 4. Fine, we got d1, this is our d1. Let me put it in red box. This is our d1. Okay, this is our d1. Fine. And this is our d2. Let me put this as well in a box. Okay, this is our d2. Now, according to the condition, what is the condition over here? We have to see this. The condition is d1 has to be equals to d2. Fine, let's equate them. Okay, when we equate them, d1 equals to d2, what we are getting? We will get this, that is x, that is d1 is x squared minus 4x plus 29, and d2 is x squared plus 4x plus 85. Let's square on both sides. Squaring on both the sides, or squaring on both sides, what we will get? We will get x squared minus 4x plus 29 equals to x squared plus 4x plus 85. If we cancel out this x squared and x squared, what we will get? We get minus 4x plus 29 equals to 4x plus 85. So on further simplification, what we'll get? We will get 8x equals to minus 56. And that gives us x equals to minus 56 divided by 8. That is nothing but negative 7, minus 7. Okay? So, what we are actually finding, we are finding the values of this, the third coordinate, the coordinates of the third point. And what we got x as? We got x as minus 7. And we already have y as 0. So, if we go up here, what we got? We got this third x as minus 7 and y is 0. So this is our answer.
So that's it for today. Hope you have understood this problem solving session. We'll be coming up with more such sessions, so stay tuned to us. And yes, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Also, press the bell icon to never miss an update from us.